Welcome back to SnowRunner on Hard Mode. At the end of the last episode, we'd reached rank 4, which unlocks some important upgrades for our scout vehicles. So let's switch back to the Chevy and head to the garage in Smithfield Dam. As I mentioned in an earlier episode, I'm going to sell the 5.2 engine due to its excessive fuel consumption. I'll install the raised suspension upgrade, which will also allow us to install 38-inch off-road tyres. The autonomous winch is expensive, but will likely pay for itself over time, as it will hopefully save us from needing to pay for any recoveries or to send another rescue vehicle. I'm going to add a snorkel, which will aid with water crossings. And while we have unlocked the trunk repair supplies, I don't think the cost is justified for only 50 repair points and one spare tyre. The Smithfield Dam map has a few more challenging areas than the Black River map, but with the upgrades installed, it should be manageable. Heading down the hill adjacent to the garage will lead us to a watchtower. In tight sections like this, I find dropping down to low gear and using the handbrake to lock the rear wheels will allow us to steer and keep the front of the vehicle pointing down the hill. This is another section where using the low gear will make things easier. At the bottom of the hill, we can head along the shore of the river and discover a scout fuel carrier, which we can turn in later to complete a task. The wet sand here can cause the Chevy to get stuck, but the winch should be able to reach the fuel trailer while also staying in range of a tree that's in front, just in case we get stuck. The quickest way up the hill is to take the rocky path ahead. Try to maintain some momentum, as the trailer can easily get caught on the rocks. I'll leave the scout carrier parked here for now instead of turning it in to complete the task. I'll use it to refuel vehicles. As long as we return the trailer with at least 10% of its fuel remaining, it will still be accepted to complete the mission. Even with the off-road tyres, the Chevy still struggles in deep mud. So the next upgrade we need is the lock differential, which will require us to take a narrow path parallel to the river. When dropping off a ledge like this, try to keep the vehicle as square as possible, otherwise it may tip over. Instead of returning the way we came, we can head up the hill and discover another Chevy CK1500. The second Chevy is drivable, but it does have damage. I'll park the red Chevy here as I accidentally hit the tree stump driving out of here on more than one occasion on previous playthroughs. The road back along the top of the hill is currently blocked, so it's time to switch back to the Fleet Star. I'm going to head to the lumber mill to pick up some wooden planks which we'll need for a later mission. I'll unload the planks at the garage temporarily so we can pick up some service spare parts to complete the long way mission. The Fleet Star should be able to make it through the water crossing, but there are plenty of winch points around if it does get stuck. With the rocks cleared, this opens up the easiest path to bring our scout vehicles back. As it has damage, the found CK-1500 will use additional fuel and may randomly drop out of gear, but we should be able to get it back to where the Fleet Star is parked. I'm not a fan of towing scout vehicles with the winch unless absolutely necessary, so I'll use the crane to load the found CK-1500 into the bed to take it back to the garage, as this is less likely to cause damage to either vehicle. I'll take as much remaining fuel in the found Chevy as possible before moving it into the garage. As we don't need two of these, I'm going to sell this vehicle and we still have the International Scout 800 as a backup. With the Chevy back in the garage, I'll install the engageable diff lock upgrade. Back to the Fleet Star, we can pick up another load of service spare parts and complete the Rock On mission. With the road opened, we can go back and load the wooden planks we brought over from Black River, as the last task on Smithfield Dam to open the roads is a wooden bridge which needs to be built. We've now completed all the roadworks tasks on the Smithfield Dam map, so I'll leave it there for this episode. Thanks for watching.